Alright guys, we are going to an engagement shoot today and it's going to be out at the beach. The original goal of today's shoot, was to do a golden hour video. However, right now the clouds are super dramatic, which is going to be a pro for this shoot. So what we're going to be talking about today is how to make your photos look dramatic during kind of a rainier photo shoot style when there's lots of clouds during sunset. So let's get this one started. Now, when you're out taking photos, always try to adjust your settings for the type of photo you want to capture, whether that be an overexposed image, an underexposed image, or perfectly exposed image. Now, on a wedding day, I always go for perfectly exposed images because that's what I want when I'm editing them. But when you're getting creative, especially when you have cool clouds and contrast, get the end result in camera first. Even though you can play around in Lightroom and make it the effect you want, it's a good habit as a photographer to learn your camera inside and out. Like if you want to underexpose the photo and have the clouds really, really dark, like, or overexpose it on purpose, make sure you do that in camera. That's going to be today's exercise. I'm going to talk to you guys how I'm doing this. And then we're going to take the photos and edit them in Lightroom. So let's get this shoot started. Let's go.
I'm a fool for that shake in your thumbs. I'm a fool for that sound in your sighs. I'm a fool for your belly. I'm a fool for your love. I wanna make this play.
Down there. So for this photo, you can stand in front of him and you're gonna bear hug her from behind. And you guys can look in opposite directions for this photo.
Right now we're shooting at ISO 250 with my 135mm f2 lens at aperture f2.8 and a shutter speed of 1/2000th of a second. Now because the sun was going down, I was actually getting pretty dark, so that's why I raised my ISO a little bit so I could have a faster shutter speed. Because they're moving a lot, I wanted to make sure I captured a sharp image. I was shooting at 2.8 because I wanted a shallow depth of field, but I also wanted enough of them in focus. But I was shooting at 2.8 because I was just kind of focusing on her when she was on these rocks. So let's move on to the next scene.
Awesome, so you can wrap your arm around her and you guys can hold hands with the other two. Like that, and you guys can look at each other. Now, what are you most looking forward to for your wedding? And you can tell each other what you're most looking forward to. Yeah. No kidding. The official. Awesome guys, so for this photo, you guys are gonna be starting right here. And it's gonna be kind of a sequence. So you guys are gonna be holding hands. You're gonna do two leaps, one, two. And then after the second leap, you guys are gonna catch each other. You can either do a spin or just kind of going for a hug. And then you're gonna brace yourselves again. You're gonna do two leaps again, one, two. And then you're going for a little dip and a kiss. All right, whenever you guys are ready.
Now, a big thing I love touching on with photo shoots is make my couples laugh by using natural movement. So by adding little sequences for them to follow where they can do two leaps going for a spin and then go for another two leaps and going for a dip, it gives them something to do. They're gonna naturally have fun while they're doing it. They're gonna remember that they had a good time doing it. And then it's actually just gonna naturally bring out candid moments instead of telling them to stand stand there in the distance and look at a rock. It's a little different. For sure, do both, but that's how I like to bring out natural, candid laughter. So as the sun was setting, there was a lot of dramatic lines that was happening with the clouds. So when I got them going on the rocks, I was able to position my camera to have the lines in the sunset and the sun behind them in different areas. Now if I was shooting very low and shooting up towards them, it would just be clouds behind them. Now if I was standing, then there'd be the water and the leading lines of the lake and then the horizon and the sky. And so always practice going up, down, low to position your camera differently to get different angles and perspectives. Now a fun way to add creativity into your photo shoots is to do double exposures. Now I'm going to do another video specifically about double exposures, but you can see me taking the first photo, I run back, and then what I'm doing is I'm composing them within themselves, so you will see the end results now.
Now you guys can actually go back to back, looking at different directions. Yeah.
Alright guys, that wraps up this video. I want to help you guys with any questions that you have, so comment below what you're struggling with right now, or what you need help with as a photographer. And give this video a thumbs up because I worked a little bit on the video, took some time to edit. And subscribe if you haven't. Welcome to the channel. We're all about becoming a better photographer and hanging out, making a meaningful impact in life. So I'll see you guys in the next one. We're going to continue hanging out in the office. Have a great day. Take awesome photos, squad. Woo!